We'll talk about the air, but it is the most important thing in the room around me. Without that, nothing else happens. Speaking and listening are the air of education. It's not that they haven't been important, it's what everything else depends upon. It's just we haven't looked at it. And when I got into education, it was quite apparent that kids didn't speak well. I cared about this, and I quickly realized that there were no materials to teach kids how to speak well. So I was committed to doing something to improve student speech. What I wanted to do was come up with six trait speaking, if you will. A simple framework that would tell teachers how to tell students what it takes to be an effective speaker. And so I decided to come up with poise, voice, life, eye contact, gestures, and speed, not aware at the time that it was PVLEGS.
What I like about the framework is that teachers can use it at every grade level and in every subject area. Kids memorize it in a minute, and they really take to it. It may sound a little silly, but it works.
P for poise. And teachers will say things like, stop fidgeting, stand still, hold your head up, good posture. Poise. You just need to be poised. You need to appear calm and confident. And so many things we throw out as volume, projection, speak loudly. Voice. You just have to have a voice such that I can hear every word.
With that said, the witness knows exactly what happened.
Life is probably the biggest, the L. And teachers will say things like vocal expression, inflection, life. You gotta have life in your voice.
Wow, so many options.
E is eye contact. And that's something that every teacher has mentioned across America. Somehow that's the one thing we know. You have to make eye contact, we got that one. G is gestures, but not just hand gestures. Faces can be very expressive, bodies can be expressive. We need to teach kids how to use face, hands, and body effectively. And the S is for speed. Pay attention to speed. Sometimes you may need to slow down. Sometimes you speed up for effect. Sometimes you pause, because pauses can be dramatic. So all of the things that I think it takes to be a great performer of a talk really fit into that little framework. I think we have this mystique about speaking generally in education. We think it's somehow scarier than other things, and that some kids aren't going to be good at it. Maybe we shouldn't even have kids do it. We don't have that with anything else. I'll give you a hint, there are kids that don't like math. And yet at a very early age, we start teaching them math.